And like I said, Canelo right now is the biggest star, the fighter who delivers action-packed fights. And without any further ado, I would like to introduce to you to the new WBO 154-pound champion, Saul Canelo Alvarez.
Muchas gracias. Gracias a todos por estar aquí, como siempre.
Y pues, thank you.
Muy agradecido con toda la gente que me brindó este gran apoyo. La verdad que tuvimos una gran noche para México.
Thank you. Thank you all for being here. I want to thank everybody for all the support in this great event. And I'm so proud for all the people from Mexico and, you know, for this big victory that we had for Mexico.
Gracias.
Okay. Any questions? Let's open up for questions.
Saul, ¿cómo fue entrando al ring, mirando la arena? Ya sé que has peleado varias veces en la gran escena. Ahora aquí en el estadio.
No, la verdad que es impresionante. Es impresionante. La verdad que estoy muy agradecido con toda la gente. Es una gran motivación para mí el ver todo ese gran apoyo. Siempre lo he dicho, es el apoyo de la gente de Texas es muy especial. Muy especial, la verdad que estoy muy agradecido y espero volver pronto a Texas.
The question was, how did you feel walking out to this stadium and being in the ring and seeing all those people? And he said, look, I'm very gracious. I'm very thankful. I'm very gracious. I've always said it. I get the best support here in Texas and the fans here in Texas. You know, what can I say? They're the best, and I want to thank them. But, you know, I'm very gracious for all the support.
Question for Canelo over here. Canelo, you went to the ropes on several occasions. Were you trying to rest, or were you trying to set traps for him?
Me siento cómodo en las cuerdas. La verdad que en el gimnasio trabajo mucho esa parte. Me siento cómodo y por eso lo hago.
I feel comfortable when I'm in the ropes. That's something that I actually practice and I train for. And when I'm in the gym, so I just that's all I can say. I just feel comfortable being on the ropes.
Canelo, do you have a diagnosis on the knuckle? Is everything okay?
Espero que sí. lo que se ve, no lo tengo quebrado ni nada. Nomás me lastimé desde el segundo asalto. Mañana voy a ir al doctor a ver qué es lo que realmente tenemos.
I hope so. You know, I injured it in the second round, and it doesn't appear to be broken. But we'll see. I'm going to go see a doctor tomorrow, and hopefully it's nothing bad.
Saul, primero que nada, felicidades. Muchas felicidades. Siempre es, ha sido un placer ver tus peleas, últimamente cada vez más intensas. Te lastimaste el nudillo en el segundo round. ¿Fue parte de la estrategia después de lastimarte el nudillo al empezar a utilizar el gancho al hígado? ¿Castigarlo de esa manera tan certera a la zona hepática fue parte de tu estrategia o fue por la lesión del nudillo que empezaste a voltear a usar el gancho al hígado?
Mira, estuvimos practicando mucho el golpeo abajo, los ganchos, la mano izquierda, pero la tuve que utilizar todavía más porque me dolía mucho la mano derecha, más cuando en los golpes rectos. Entonces tuve que utilizarla más y es lo que siempre digo, que hay que estar listos para cualquier cosa, para poder cambiar el rumbo de una pelea, así como lo hice, ¿no? Entonces fue que tuve que utilizar más la izquierda.
The question was, you know, it seemed that, you know, you said yourself you hurt your right hand and you started going in the body a lot. Was that a result of the injury, or was it something that you trained for? And Saul said, no, that's what we trained for. We worked hard on going to the body in this fight. Yes, after I got hurt, I probably used my left hand a little more and went to the body a little bit more. But it was part of the game plan. And I've always said it, you know, you got to be prepared for anything in that ring. And that's what I was. I was prepared for anything.
Those knockouts. Were you surprised you got up from the first body shot? And when you hit him with the second one to end the fight, did you think you were
going to
get up?
No. Cuando lo golpeé, lo sentí que le dolió. Cuando lo golpeé ahí abajo, sentí que le dolió y quiso aguantarse un poco, pero los golpeé Son demasiado dolorosos.
No, I, you know, when I hit him down there, I knew I hurt him. He was trying to hide it, but I knew that I got him with a good shot. And it, you know, look, body shots hurt. They hurt a lot, and I knew that I hurt him.
Saul, por más que estuvieron a Liam, ¿te esperabas la respuesta que dio esta noche?
Sí. Sí, sabíamos que era un rival fuerte, que aguantaba, que pensaba arriba del cuadrilátero también. Sus combinaciones son muy buenas. Es un rival joven también. No por nada es campeón mundial. Sabíamos, ¿no? Y obviamente también mi mano derecha pues tuvo mucho que ver en esta pelea, pero me gustó porque así le brindé una mejor pelea a la gente.
The question was Liam Smith what you expected? What you expected? And he said, no, look, I said it from the get-go. I knew he was going to be a tough fighter, and I prepared for a tough fighter, you know? And he's exactly what we thought. You know, obviously with the injury, it was going to be a little bit tougher with the injury, but look, I'm just happy that we gave a great fight for the fans, and that's what makes me really happy.
Saúl, para la gente que todavía duda de la calidad de Saúl Canelo Álvarez, en sus dos últimas peleas, knockouts espectaculares que han puesto de pie a todo el mundo, que han puesto a la gente al filo de la butaca, un knockout impresionante con Amir Khan, ahora este, un knockout en la zona hepática, que es de los knockouts más espectaculares para muchos, que solamente pudo masterizar Julio César Chávez. ¿Esto va a cambiar tu estilo de pelea? ¿Habré encontrado este tipo de knockout o te vas a mantener?
No, mira, no te preocupes por los que no creen. Nunca van a creer. Entonces, hay que preocuparnos por los que de verdad creen. Gracias a Dios, estoy muy agradecido con la gente. Aquí es lo que se ve, ¿no? Entonces, estoy muy agradecido. Yo lo único que hago en mi vida es entrenar al 100%, dedicarme 100% a este deporte y entregarle a la gente buenas peleas y obviamente a mi gente, a mi equipo, a la gente que está alrededor, a la gente que me quiere.
The question was, you know, you're coming off two spectacular knockouts. Do you think you're gonna change the doubters? And he said, look, the doubters are going to be the doubters. They're always going to be that way. I don't worry about the doubters. I worry about the people that came out and support me. That's who I fight for. All I do is train hard for them to give them victories and to win. And I think I did it tonight.
Saúl, el tema de el título que tanto querías que un mexicano no había podido ganar de la UFC 154, ¿es tu despedida de oro de esta categoría? ¿Ya emigras a la 160 oficialmente?
Eso es lo que vamos a platicar con mi equipo. Eso es lo que vamos a platicar con mi equipo. Yo le dije a mi equipo que si nos íbamos a ir de las 154 libras, nos íbamos a ir con el pie derecho, y creo que esta será la última.
The question was, you know, you want the title now. It's something that you wanted to do. No Mexicans ever won the WBO 154 title. You know, are you now going to vacate and move up and wait, or what's your plan? And he said, look, I'm going to sit down with my team. I'm going to sit down with my team. I said, and we've always said all along in my team, that if I ever leave the 154-pound division, I'm going to leave as a champion, and I think I did it. So we're going to sit down, we'll see. This might be my last fight at 54, I'm not sure yet.
Y por último, el tema de Golovkin, ¿te gustaría que ahora que se hizo público de parte de Oscar, de ti, de que ya se le puso una cantidad de 8 cifras en la mesa, deje de retarte y de burlarse de ti y firme el contrato?
De mí no se burla nadie. Yo no me siento así. Creo que, como lo dije, no lo podía decir antes de la pelea, como lo dije, hacen ver que uno es el que no quiere la pelea, ¿no? Ya le ofrecimos lo doble o lo triple de lo que ha ganado. Ya nomás está en él que acepte.
The question was about Golovkin. You know, obviously Oscar mentioned that, you know, made him a significant offer. Do you think that that's going to stop him heckling you? And he said, no, I don't care about the heckling. You know, nobody heckles me. They can't get to me. I mean, you know, what it does, though, is, you know, for people out there, the doubters that say that I'm running away from the fight, we made him a significant offer. It's 2 or 3 times the most he's ever made in his career. If he really wants to fight, then take the offer. If not, then, you know, move on.
Sí, acá.
Gracias.
Saúl, felicidades por este nuevo campeonato. Vengo de un programa en donde varios campeones y excampeones coinciden en que es el rostro del boxeo. Y utilizamos una frase que tú usas mucho, es mi era. Seguramente, y hoy lo corroboras, es tu era, Saúl.
más responsabilidad y más compromiso seguramente para ti.
Así es una gran responsabilidad para mí, pero me considero alguien responsable, alguien dedicado a este deporte al 100%, disciplinado, que ama lo que hace, y creo que con eso se asume esa responsabilidad. Esta es mi era y va a ser la mejor.
The question was, you know, all of us have been commenting that, and you said it yourself that it's your era. How does that make you feel? Do you feel that you have more responsibility? And he said, of course, yes, it is my era. I feel that it's my time now, but I love what I do. I love what I do, and you know, I have a lot of discipline, and I take it serious. And when you love what you do, then you know you do your best, and that's what I think I'm doing.
Yeah, so por acá, gracias. Buenas noches. Hace 42 minutos exactamente, el presidente de México te felicita en su cuenta de Twitter. Te lo digo textualmente. Muchas felicidades, Saúl Canelo Álvarez, por este gran triunfo. Sigues demostrando que eres un campeón.
Pues muchas gracias.
The president in Mexico just tweeted, congratulations to Saul, you're a great champion, you keep showing our people. And Saul said, well, thank you very much. Okay, wait, hold on, there's one over here, go ahead, over here.
Hello, over here.
Okay.
Canelo, my question for you, there's been a lot of discussion about Gennady Golovkin here. I'm curious if you got an opportunity to see his fight last week. He got a knockout win, but he got marked up quite a bit by a welterweight. Did you see it, and if so, what did you think?
Sí, lo vimos. Pues no es nada raro para mí. Yo creo que nosotros ya sabemos lo que es. Simplemente no es nada especial lo que vi.
Yes, I did see the fight, and it wasn't nothing rare, nothing different. You know, he is who he is, and we know him very well.
For you, Canelo, is do you think that, I know you said that you're going to wait and see a doctor tomorrow, but the way that your hand feels, do you think that it could be ready to have another fight in December? And if you do have a fight in December, and you go up in weight, will you go all the way to 160, or you go in the middle and work your way up?
Vamos a ver mañana cómo está mi mano. Vamos a ver la realidad de cómo está mi mano y ver qué es lo que, si peleamos en diciembre o no. Y lo del peso, pues también lo vamos a ver. Como lo dije, ya fue mi última pelea en 154 libras.
We're gonna go see the doctor. You know, I really can't say right now. I want to get it checked out. I want to make sure that I'm fine. I can't really say right now. But let's see. Let's see what the prognosis is from the doctor, and then we'll make a decision. And you know, about the weight, we're gonna decide. We'll see. But you know, right now, the way I feel, this is probably my last fight I wanted to fight. Okay.
Bueno, yes. Chavo Rodriguez.
Okay, dale.
Canelo, un par de preguntas rápido. Vas a invadir la división de los medianos. ¿Qué nombres son los que te interesan o que te atraen de la división para no seguir sacrificándote en 154 libras? ¿Y qué es lo que te mueve después de haber impuesto marca en este estadio, después de haber convocado a tanta gente, después de dominar las 154 libras y prácticamente convertirte ya en uno de los 5, me parece, 3 mejores libra por libra del mundo al lado de Román González y Dolor? ¿Qué te mueve a ti? ¿Pelear en otra nación? ¿Ir a Nueva York? ¿O qué te mueve?
Mira, para empezar, de la división, los mejores de las 160 que estén ahí, ¿no? Y después de esto, la verdad que estoy muy agradecido con toda la gente, el apoyo que me brindó, y seguir haciendo historia en mi carrera. Eso es lo que me motiva, lo que me levanta cada mañana a correr, lo que me hace tener esa dieta rigurosa, aguantarla. Creo que es lo que más me motiva, y quiero hacer historia y seguir haciendo historia en este deporte.
The question was a two-part question. The first one, you know, after tonight it's imminent that you're going to go to 160. Who would you like to fight there? And after what you saw tonight, the attendance tonight, what is it you want to keep doing in boxing, or what other stadiums or places would you like to fight in? And he said, you know, as far as I want to make history. That's the most important thing. I'll fight the best, all the best champions at 160. I'm gonna want to fight the best. I always want to fight the best, you know. And as far as, you know, stadiums or sites or whatever, I just want to make history. I want to keep making history.
And Canelo, on the heels of this performance, you said, I'm the best boxer in the planet now. What was it? Was that a result of something that happened in the ring tonight? or what did you accomplish in there that makes you say that?
A muchos no les va a gustar y muchos van a decir que no, pero soy el mejor.
A lot of people aren't going to agree with it, but I'm the best.
All right, one last question. Last one.
Yeah, for you, Oscar, I just wanted to ask. Tom Loeffler said that the offer that was presented was not substantial enough for him to act on right now. Was that an offer that was made for a September 2017 fight? So it's still out there and negotiations can still go on for that?
Then at least give me a call. Call me back and we can talk about it. But you just don't leave anybody hanging out there and not do anything about it. So all you can do is talk in the media and bash and this and that. Let's talk about it.
You know, Lance, Oscar mentioned it too. You know, he did an interview with you, and he said that in his interview, and I quote him, you know, we have it recorded somewhere, but he said, oh, I know they're going to make me a bullshit offer, $2 million, right? That's the amount he said, right? $2 million? And he said, you know, but they're clowns, and Canelo's going to find a way. They'll make the offer $2 million. He's still going to find a way to get out of the fight, and I'm ready to take the fight. Well, I can tell you this, Oscar. Want to speak on the $2 million?
It was a substantial amount of money, let's put it that way.
At least five times more than that.
Hey, Oscar.
Muchas gracias a todos. Gracias por estar aquí. Gracias.